Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video we'll be going over another use case of models generated with photogrammetry. In last week's video I showed you how to easily capture the needed images and integrate your model in a simple scene, but today I'm going to show you how to generate 2D textures from these models. The reason behind we'd want to do this is that using this technique we'll get accurate height values for our texture. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said, let's get started. So, in this tutorial, we'll be creating a ground floor texture from these images. You can see, to create a model from a simple 2D texture, you don't need any specific angles. Top-down photos will just do the trick. You also don't need many, I'll only use 5 today. So let's go ahead and drag and drop these images into Reality Capture. And you can see that this time I've taken them with a DSLR camera and not with a phone, because Reality Capture can actually detect my model and all the other data it needs. So we'll have less trouble creating a final model from these images. Of course, as always, let's go to Alignment and click on Align Images. This will take a few seconds and generate a point cloud like this one. And you can see it recognized that this was just a ground, and overall everything looks correct. But of course, the domain is rotated right here, so let's fix that. To do this, navigate over to the Reconstruction tab, and let's first click on Set Ground Plane. This will allow us to rotate our point cloud. To do this correctly, let's head over to the Scene tab, and right here under Display, we can choose the viewing angle. So let's go into the left view, and you can see that this is already rotated correctly. And now we just have to switch the views to, for example, front, rotate it, so it looks correct. And to have a look at our final setup, you'll have to switch back to perspective, and now we can rotate around our model. And with these small arrows, we can move the point cloud up and down. So let's again go to any side view and move our point cloud onto our ground plane right here. Great, now we can switch back to perspective, and in the Reconstruction tab, click on Set Reconstruction Region. And this already did a great job. We can basically leave it right here. The next step would be to generate an actual mesh, and you can choose to either do it in normal or high detail. For this tutorial, I'll do it in normal detail because this will generate much faster. Okay, the model has been generated. Now only the texture is missing. And after that, we can import it into Blender to extract the height detail. So let's click on Colorize, give it a few seconds, and then click on Texture. Now that our texture has been created, we want to export this model. For this I had to pay 20 cents, because I only used 5 images. If you don't want to pay for your models, you can try Meshroom. I personally just got better results with Reality Capture. But of course, this decision is up to you. And in the end, you only want your model with a basic diffuse texture. Now that I have exported my model, I'll just import it back into Blender. Okay, the model has been imported. And you can see that the rotation is off. So let's quickly fix it by rotating it on the x-axis, and if we go into the material preview mode, you can see that the texture is already assigned. Now, how do we best extract these textures? Well, because the actual texture isn't really usable, we'll have to render out a top-down image of our model. This way we can also easily export our height information. For this, we'll first need to set up a camera. So let's add in one and clear out its location and rotation. Move it upwards and change it to orthographic. We'll also need a square resolution. For this tutorial, this is going to be 1K. Now to enlarge our view, we just have to adjust the orthographic scale, and we basically want to get as much out of our texture as possible, just like this. And now if we go into rendered mode and control click on our image texture in the shader editor, you can see that this will be the final texture export. But this only is the diffuse texture, we still need the height one. For this, we can get the position output of our geometry node and separate just the z-axis. This isolates the height. You can see that if I move the model, also the height information changes. So we want to make sure that the lowest point of our texture is roughly on level 0 in our scene. But you can see that the way the model was imported, this already works out. For this tutorial, I'll only export the textures as PNGs, but still with a 16-bit color depth. For final textures, especially for the height one, I'd use the OpenEXR file format. So let's render our image and save it. And do the same for your color. There's one thing to note here. The texture is already pretty evenly lit, so in this case I don't have to equalize the texture. This might be different for you, so if the light changes in your image, you can watch this tutorial by CG Meta to learn how to equalize your texture. But in this case I'm lucky, so I can just save this image. You can of course try to generate a roughness map from your color, but because the export process would stay the same, I won't go over this. Now the last thing left to do is to make this texture tileable. In this tutorial I'll just use the Tile Seamless filter in GIMP. You can see what it does right here. Of course, this won't work for every texture, but for this one it luckily does. The reason why I use it is because it makes it easy to apply it both to our color and height map. If you would try to paint over the seams with a clone stamp tool, you would have to imitate it perfectly on the other textures. So this way is just the easiest. And after I've done this, I'll also export these textures from GIMP. And these are the final results. We can now go back into Blender and import them on a plane just for testing purposes. So let's set up a quick scene in Cycles so we can use micro displacement for the height texture. And for this just add in a adaptive subdivision modifier. Give it a new material and we can now just drag and drop these images into the shader editor. And let's have a look. The color texture already looks great and the displacement map also seems to work. Of course right now we can only see bump, so let's go into settings and change it to displacement and bump. And let's turn down the scale. And if we would go ahead and tile our texture, you can see that the tiling is of course noticeable, but there are no seams visible. So I'd call this one a success. And yeah, that's about it. This is how we can use photoscanned models to create 2D textures with accurate height information. If you found this tutorial helpful, consider liking and subscribing. And we'll see you in the next video, next Saturday.